In this part of our training, we'll talk about the basics of what goes into creating thunderstorms. All thunderstorms need three ingredients to get going. They need lift, they need moisture, and they need instability. However, strong to severe thunderstorms have a fourth element as well, wind shear. We'll talk about these individually coming up. First off, we need to lift the air in order to create a thunderstorm. A common way to lift the air involves fronts, low pressure systems, and wind shift lines. In this example on the left side, the air is flowing upward as it reaches the cold front and creating thunderstorms. Another way that we can create lift is also through the jet stream. Also, we can create lift by heating the ground. As the heat of the day increases, warm air will rise from the ground, creating a thermal and often producing clouds as well with it. And a fourth way of lifting the air is what we call outflow boundaries, coming from additional thunderstorms. In this particular image, this ring that is going across the central part of the image is outflow from previous thunderstorms, and we'll talk about that a little more later on. The air also needs to be moist. Here in central Illinois, we have two typical sources for moisture. First off is air flowing up from the Gulf of Mexico into the Midwest. And as we also get into later into the season, local vegetation will be a source of moisture, especially corn crops. We also need a way to keep the air moving after the thunderstorms form. This is called instability. Air forced upwards, what we call an updraft, will continue to rise, and air forced downward, or what we call a downdraft, will continue to sink. Think of it like a hot air balloon. As the hot air balloon is heated, it rises because the air inside of it is unstable. However, when the heat is turned off, it starts to sink again because the air is becoming stable. Wind shear is a change in wind direction or wind speed as the further up you go into the atmosphere. When wind direction changes, that's called directional shear, and when wind speed changes, that is called speed shear. With a strong wind shear, storms tend to be more organized. They also tend to be longer lived. Rotation can also develop in a storm when you have strong wind shear. In this particular example, notice that the clouds that are moving into the screen are moving from a different direction than the clouds higher up, which are moving from left to right. This is an example of directional and wind speed shear.